Hello and welcome to the MATLAB Programming for Computation course. We are in module 1, Introduction to MATLAB Programming. We are going to do lecture 1-3 over here, where we are going to cover loop and execution control. Specifically, we are going to talk about for and while loops. Okay? So the loops, the two main loops in MATLAB are as shown over here, the for loop and the while loop. The command for for loop is of the form for I equal to 1:10, a bunch of statements followed by the command end. Okay? So these number of these statements are going to be repeated 10 times. Let us say we wanted to repeat it for values of I equal to 1, 3, 5, so on and so forth until 10. Okay? We will use the same column notations as before. We will say 1:2:10, and that should work for I equal to 1 to 10 in steps of 2. Okay, this is something again what we have seen in one of the earlier lectures. We can use the same concepts in order to use it in the for loop. The other loop is called the while loop. The while loop commands will be executed as long as the condition that we state over here is true. So let us say we start with I equal to 1 and we keep repeating as long as the value of I is less than 10. So we will repeat it for value of I equal to 1, I equal to 2, I equal to 3, so on and so forth until I equal to 9. When the value, after executing this for the 9th time, when we come across this particular statement, the value of I is going to be equal to 10. So I equal to I plus 1 will be 10. When we then go for this particular statement with the execution going back to the first line, right now I equal to 10, which violates the command, which violates the condition I less than 10, because I equal to 10 is not less than 10, and it will exit this while loop. So if I write this particular loop with starting with I equal to 1, this loop is going to be executed 9 times. Okay? So, where to use for loops? For loops should be used when a set of operations are to be repeated a specific number of times. If we know approximately how many number of times a particular operation is going to be repeated, we should use for loop. For example, if we want to find the first 10 terms of a Fibonacci series, we can use a for loop for doing this. To find a factorial of a number n, we can use a for loop, because we know that we need to do this for a specific number of times. Now, when to use while loop? While loop is used when a set of operations is to be repeated until a certain condition is met. For example, if we want to find the Fibonacci series, not the first 10 terms of the series, but the find the values till the value of the last term becomes greater, until the value of the last term is less than 200, then we will use a while loop. Because what we want to do is not repeat a particular statement for a specific number of times, but we want to repeat it until a condition is met. So let's go to MATLAB and do this Fibonacci series example using a for loop. So let's say edit FIBO using for, okay, and it's going to prompt me, yes, okay. I'm going to write a comment over here, Fibonacci series using for loop, let's say n equal to 10, we wanted to repeat it 10 times, FIBO equal to 1, 1, okay. Why 1, 1? We need two elements in order to start the Fibonacci series. If you recall, Fibonacci series is any nth element of the Fibonacci series is just the sum of n minus 1 and n minus 2th element. So the first guy is 1, second guy is 1, the third one is 1 plus 1, that is 2, the fourth one is 2 plus 1, that is 3, the next guy is 3 plus 2, that is 5, the guy after that is 5 plus 3 equal to 8, so on and so forth. Okay, so now we will use for loop for I equal to 3 to n. Why 3? Because we already have the first two guys. Okay, so we are not going from 1 to n, we are going from 3 to n, and we will say FIBO I, that is the next element, is going to be equal to FIBO I minus 1 plus FIBO I minus 2 and end. Okay. Save this and run this FIBO using for and press enter, and I am going to get the Fibonacci series. You can see this in the workspace over here. I will type this out by typing FIBO and pressing enter. So, we now have the first 10 terms of the Fibonacci series. Okay. So, let us say now we wanted to convert it into a Fibonacci series using a while loop, and we wanted to do this until the element becomes equal to or greater than 200. The last element has to be less than 200, and that is the condition that we will use. So, edit FIBO using while. Okay, so we have FIBO equal to 1, 1, and let me put a comment over here, Fibonacci series until 200 using while loop. Okay, so FIBO 1, 1, okay, while FIBO end, which is the last element of FIBO, is less than 200. So, as long as the last element of FIBO is less than 200, I am going to repeat the steps. FIBO new equal to FIBO end, that is the last term from the previous series, and FIBO end minus 1. Okay. Now, next what we are going to do is we are going to expand the array FIBO with the FIBO new term, and I will say this as FIBO comma FIBO new, okay, square brackets, not circular brackets over here, and end. Okay. And once I do this, I am going to be able to run this particular code until the value of the Fibonacci series reaches up to 200 or below 200. Okay. So, this is the same thing that we did earlier, initializing FIBO as 1, 1 until the last element of the vector FIBO is less than 200, the while loop is going to be repeated. The new element, which has to be appended at the end of the FIBO, is going to be equal to the sum of the last two elements. The last element is extracted using the code word called end. End extracts the last element of any vector or an array. So, FIBO end is going to extract the last element of FIBO, and FIBO end minus 1 is going to extract the second last element. So, I am sorry, this should be plus and not minus over here. Okay. And then FIBO is going to be FIBO and the last element that has been extracted. I save this and run this FIBO using while. I press enter and I get my FIBO. I type FIBO and this is what I get. So, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5 and so on up to 233. And the reason why I actually got that element 233 is because this loop was repeated when the element 233 was already present in the FIBO loop. Now, if I did not want that particular element in the FIBO array, I just need to do FIBO end equal to blank. What this is going to do is it is going to replace the last element with null, which basically means it's nothing but killing the last element. And I can do that, and let me now try that over here using FIBO using while. Okay. And now, when I type FIBO, I am going to get 1 to 144. The 233, which is 89 plus 144, is no longer present. The other way to do this, instead of using FIBO end equal to blank, the other way to do this is to do type FIBO equal to FIBO 1:end-1. Okay. That is the other way to type this. This is the type of format that we have been using so far. is this is the standard colon notations, and colon's notations is going not from 1 to end, but 1 to end minus 1. So all the elements except the last element is going to be extracted out of the array FIBO and reassigned to the same array FIBO. Okay, let's try this out again. I will give the command clear all to clear all the workspace arrays. Okay, and type FIBO using while. Note that I am not typing the command. I know that I have recently used that command, so I am just going to use up array in order to select a previous command and type enter and type FIBO, and I am going to get the Fibonacci series. Okay, what we have computed is Fibonacci series until 233, and when it comes across this particular command, it is going to extract the first 12 elements and not the last element from that particular array. So we will have the array up to 233, and then the last element is going to be removed and the first 12 elements are going to be reassigned to the array FIBO. Okay? So that is how we have calculated first 10 terms of a Fibonacci series or all the terms of Fibonacci series less than 200. Okay? Now, let's think about the example that we saw in the first lecture, that was of Dhoni hitting a 6. In that example, what we did was Dhoni has hit the ball, and we were trying to compute how the ball trajectory is going to be until the ball reaches the ground. Let's create another example where the ball is hit vertically instead of at an angle. Let's say that the ball is hit vertically with a velocity of v0. Okay, so when it's hit vertically with a velocity of v0, there's gravity that is acting against it in the downward direction. So the ball is going to go vertically upwards. It's going to reach a certain height. Its velocity is going to go 0, and then it's going to fall downwards under gravity. So let's say we wanted to find the location of the of the ball that is thrown upwards at the end of every 0.1 seconds. We are going to use this particular calculation in order to get y at every 0.1 seconds. So let's do that using a while loop. Okay. So we'll say edit ball vertical. Okay. And I will say display location of ball hit vertically at every 0.1 seconds. Okay? So let's say V0 was equal to 20 meters per second, gravity was equal to 9.8 meters square per second. Okay? So we will do while y greater than or equal to 0. We are going to repeat this greater than or equal to 0. We are going to repeat this. For this, we need to predefine y equal to 0 and t equal to 0. Okay. So t is equal to t plus 0.1, because we want to compute at the end of every 0.1 seconds. Y is going to be equal to v0 multiplied by t minus g multiplied by t square divided by 2. Okay? And we want to display this at t equal to num2str t comma location equal to y. Okay, we have not yet covered how to work with strings. This is something that we are going to cover in next lecture. Okay, so just bear with me. I will take this particular example again in the fifth lecture, 1-5 lecture, and we'll go over it, and we'll say end. Okay. What I am doing over here is I am at each step whenever we are repeating this particular array, okay, I am calculating the new time, I am calculating the location y at that particular time, and I am displaying the time and location y. Okay, and I am going to repeat that so long as y is greater than or equal to 0, that means the ball is in the air and has not reached the ground. Okay, so let me do that. I will say ball vertical and press enter, and this is what I am going to get. Okay, so I started at point 1, at time point 1 we have reached 1.9 meters, at 0.2 seconds we have reached 3.8 meters, so on and so forth, and at time 4.1 we have reached below the surface. Okay, the equation is valid only until the ball reaches the surface, it is no longer valid beyond that, so we are getting an incorrect result over here. Just as before, what has happened over here is that particular loop was executed until the value reached a value a negative value. If we do not want that to happen, what simply we should be doing is we should be displaying before and not after computation of that value. And if we do that and we execute, I will just clear the screen and I will execute ball vertical, what is going to happen is the location will be displayed until the ball is in the air, not when the ball has reached the surface. And again you will see that it is starting at t equal to 0, location is equal to 0, instead of starting at t equal to 0.1. Okay? So this is the thing that I wanted to cover with respect to for loops and while loops. So just to recap, when to use for loops is to be used when a set of operations is to be repeated a specific number of times, whereas while loop is to be used when a set of operations is to be repeated as long as a certain condition is met. Okay. So with this we come to the end of this lecture. In this lecture we have covered how to use for and while loop in MATLAB. Thanks and see you in the next lecture.